would know where we could find a spark reactor. One of those wrecks gotta have one in working condition.
He's not gonna like this. Not fond of visits, that man. Especially not impromptu ones.
I brought a box of his favorite tea leaves. Hopefully enough for the trade.
What Treble said about the dirty paws, about the Whistlers, I've never even heard that name. Who are they?
What's the matter? You look like you've seen a ghost.
The Striders! I couldn't hold them back. And then the Dirty Paws showed up.
The Whistlers.
Yeah, the Whistlers. Anyway, I was sure they would kill me. But they didn't. Actually, I think they tried to...
Help you?
Yeah.
You know, all those stories you've been fed are not... I reached my target. It's all up to me now. Our scientists had devised a fluid that was meant to drip into the heart of the Dandelion and stop the machinery from running. Our mission was to pump it into one of the central vents, and that's what I did. I pumped the fluid in, plugged the vent, and I left. I didn't look back at first. The only thing I could think of was getting away. But then, when I turned my head, the entire thing had turned into a monster. Gloom shooting out like fountains of black saliva. I remember thinking of 100-armed octopuses and giant spiders, mythological creatures from my childhood stories. Then came a deafening thunder. The whole thing started to burst. Well, I guess you know the rest.
And Strandville was lost in the deep.
After what I caused, I couldn't bear to face anyone. So I settled here.
How did you survive the explosion?
All I know is that I passed out. When I woke up, the sea was calm. But the city...
My mother?
She was my friend. The bravest person I ever met. She listened to us, even after the flood. She believed me when I told her that we never meant any harm. She even wanted to help me put things right, so we set out to try and fix the damage I'd caused. But we never... She never... She was investigating methods to change the behavior of the gloom. One day she came to my hideout, looking for clues, as she put it. I told her to get lost. She wasn't easily scared. Like mother, like kid, I guess. She had been breeding flowers, you see. Some kind of modified version of the Nightweaver, an herb we grow back home. She had learned that its roots could bind the gloom back into the weave rock and stop it from spreading. She wanted me to take her to the pipe that started the rupture. Her idea was to pour some spark-induced Nightweaver seeds into the central vent and turn the Dandelion into a sort of mending machine. Don't ask me about the science. That was her forte.
So you went back there?
Yes, child. She even made us go inside. She said it was crucial. I refused at first, but your mother was a very convincing woman. And I know you won't believe me when I tell you this, but it was as though the gloom felt threatened by us. Your mother fought for her life. I lost my right leg trying to save her, and I'd gladly give my left too if that could bring her back. Since then, the gloom has kept spreading, like the plague it is.
Is there nothing left to do?
The airship manages to fight it off to some extent. Do whatever it takes to keep those morons from firing. Then you have to find Moira. Just follow the barge.
Moira?
The Whistler's leader. She's the only one who can make use of that seed. Now go!
Ciggy, I don't have time for this. Just hurry up and come home.
promise you won't do anything more until I'm there.
You're breaking up. Just bamboos on back now, will ya?
Gran? Granny?
Torch, please. Now, what's taking that girl so long? She knows I'm not fond of waiting.
Stop! Stop!
Oh, Sigrid. Nice to see that you made it back safely.
The paws don't control the gloom. They make it flower.
Make it flower? What are you rambling on about?
Grandma, I know what happened to Mom. She
died trying to save us.
The paws.
No, you don't understand. She and Rufus wanted to stop the gloom from spreading. They tried to make it into the dandelion, but the gloom got her. He tried to save her, but...
You have a kind heart, Siggy. But you must stop believing everything people tell you. You are just like your mother in that respect. And if you think I'll let us all meet our maker because of the words of some driveling bum, You are gravely mistaken.
But he...
Even if he was telling the truth, your mother wouldn't have been in any danger if she had kept away from him in the first place.
What gives you the right to always judge people like that? They were trying to save us!
Sigrid. We all understand you're upset. All this stress would get the better of anyone. And you're just a kid. No wonder you've lost your head. Now, why don't you go have a lie down and let us take care of things?
Don't touch me!
Manners, young lady. I only want to help.
You want to destroy! That's what you want! That's what all of you want! Gloom you!
Shrimps! Shrimpy!
Well, you know how teenagers are, Doris. I wasn't all that easy myself, was I? Leave her. She just needs to walk it off. And we have very important things to attend to.
I'm right by this island. The barge is just above it, and it's... Grandma, there are flowers here. I think I see apples.
No, that's not possible. Are you sure?
It's just like the stories you told me. I never thought I...
Sigrid, my dear, you are brave. I give you that. But we simply cannot conform our actions to a child's foolish whims. I am in your debt for helping us come such a long way. But now, it's time to finish what we've started. I am truly sorry, child.
No! Don't shoot!
I have to, Sigrid. It is my duty to do so. Our people want this, and I will not be stopped. The best you can do is try and save yourself.
Thank you.
brings back memories.
You've done it?
As long as my back would let me. A while longer, to be honest. But they shouldn't be here in our world. When Strandville drilled for Weave Rock year after year, the Earth's mantle cracked, and the rifts went all the way down to their domain. And if we don't repair what has been destroyed, our entire world will eventually fall into theirs.
So, a shadow came to you, too?
Yes. My oldest daughter. We lost her during the war. When the shadow came around, I just knew it was her. You do, too, right, Sigrid? You know who has come to you.
I think so. I just couldn't believe it. But it feels like her.
Wait, are you saying that thing is my daughter?
A shadow of your daughter, at least. A body for a soul who needs to make contact.
This is it. This is the vent? This is where...
Yeah!
working on it.
You think I've found another way in? I'm coming after you!
It's done. deep breaths, my darling. Waves are crashing. We are still far from shore. Know that I've got you.
She's at peace now, don't you think? What's the matter with Anita?
Easy, Doris. Nothing's wrong with her. I just thought it rude to leave an old lady in distress.
I have a feeling that particular lady knows how to take care of herself.
We did it, y'all! We spark and did it! Well, look at these weeds.
Solid stuff. I've never walked on ground that wasn't rock or sand.
You did well, all of you. Eventually. And without you, my dear girl, we never would have made it.
I saw right away that she was made of the right stuff.
Bravest little pirate there ever was. Isn't she, Doris?
Sigrid, you've done such... Why can't I just do this?
Grandma, I...
No, I have to do this. When Iris was a kid, John always took care of the mushy stuff. But when he wasn't around anymore and we lost Iris...
Oh.